the deer stand. It is my secret place, my solitude. The place where I feel most alive and the most challenged. A place where I can hear God's voice without being distracted. A place where my soul can breathe the fresh, crisp air and my five senses can take in God's creation. For me, hunting is more than a hobby, more than just an act of taking the life of a living creature. It is my way of life. For some reason, God built it into my DNA. There is a deep desire inside me that I must connect with the wilderness. All roads in my life end at the same place, the deer stand. This is a 3-month journey through the lens of a bumpy road I call Hard Knocks.
Thank you. hey guys, out here on a windy, hot day down here at my dear lease, I got Jeremy behind the cameras for me. We both had some vacation days during the same week. Jeremy went down to his place, did a run, and he decided to come pair up with me and try to get some good video footage this weekend. So we did quite a bit of work today. We actually moved the set, the one down the corner. I'm just trying to get it to where I can hunt when I have variable wind conditions. Where I had it just wasn't the greatest. So hopefully we didn't do too much down here today. We hate to move a set and hunt the set the same day, but it's pretty windy. So we think that helped cover up a lot of the noise and scent and everything that we had. So anyway, it's a little early, but the deer have been showing up early here. So we're gonna kick back and just relax and hope I have better luck than last time. Thank you.
Kevin was here earlier still.
All right, well, we had a pretty eventful night. Ended up with $5, or six, five, six. I'm not sure. Start over. All right, well, we had a pretty eventful night. Jeremy and I moved that set like we talked about earlier. Ended up proving off to be a pretty good deal. We had $5 come in tonight. They were all young, but it's more deer than what I saw at my other lease last year, so I'm pretty happy about that. There's a pretty cool 8-point that we are hoping to run into this weekend. Hadn't seen him around. I got a real unique rack. So he is being a ghost at the moment. So we'll just have to see how it goes. We got 2 more days of hunting if everything holds out. So now we got to decide what we're going to do in the morning. I really want to go back to where we were, but I don't think it's the smartest thing to do. So we'll figure it out. And just hope we have better luck in the morning.